Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to go over three data analysis tips that will help in Excel or any other application. It can really work for any scenario. With the first being to define what you're looking for. This could be what your company asked of you to find or something you want to get out of the data. So it's important to figure out what you're actually looking for. And this will lead us right into the second one, which is cleaning your data. As the first can be the hardest, defining, you know, exactly what you want to look for. If someone gives you a vague description of what they want from the data, can be difficult to pull exactly what you need, and sometimes they don't know what they're looking for. But with cleaning your data, this will be getting rid of stuff that we don't need. So let's say with all this chess data and all these games and a bunch of different things, there's openings. So let's say we want to count the amount of openings that occurred in all of these games. So a lot of stuff we can get rid of. I mean, we can get rid of a ton of these, but we will leave an ID and whether it's rated, created at. I don't know what these are, so let's just delete them. I mean, we can leave the victory status if we want to do different types of analysis, the amount of turns a game was. You could do the winner. Increment code is just, you know, for each move they play in the chess game. If they get time after each move, we don't need that. The IDs we don't really care about. So we can take both of these and you can either hide them, but we might as well delete them. The white rating, black rating, maybe we could do something like the average rating of each opening played. And the moves could be useful. We'll just leave them for now. Opening eco, delete that. We don't need it. So now, I mean, we're left with a very reasonable amount of data. So that alone already helps us not looking, you know, in different spots. So that's our second tip. Our third tip will be to plan what you want to do. Depending on the complexity of what you need to do and the different types of functions and you know how long this will take, you can spend even a minute to 30 minutes to, you know, even a day of planning. So you don't, you know, end up spending so much time looking in the wrong direction or with wrong functions. So this will be like when your knowledge of how to use functions will come into play. So we'll just do a simple, you know, in all these games, how many times have, you know, the Slav defense exchange variation occurred? So now let's plan. We want to use a count if. That will just take all these games and then we'll come back with the count of how many times each of these occurred. So let's do that. And this is obviously a more simple example. And, you know, we just spent 10, 15, 20 seconds just trying to vocalize our approach. So now equals counts. If we can do the range. Will just be this whole range. Hit F4 to make it absolute range. The criteria can be this cell, but actually we're gonna wanna do a unique function over here. So that's fine for now. And then we'll equal unique. So this is the way we'll find how many you know, different variations there are in over 20,000 cells. So now we came back with this, and now the count if is already ready. So if we copy that down, it'll tell us. We will not be able to filter in these two because this is an array. So if we try to sort largest to smallest, it will not work. So we can take that filter off. And then actually what we're going to want to do is just copy these down. And paste just the values so they're no longer in an array. And after we do that, let's just change this function to instead of K2, L2, then copy that down. We can just hide the initial unique. And then if we filter here, we can now sort. Just like that, it comes back with the openings that have been played the most to the least. And we can just put opening name, give them headers, and amount of times played. And there we go. So now we already, you know, finished our first bit of analysis, and this can go on and on for, you know, how deep you're digging into the data and what you want to find. That's all I have for you today. Please like, subscribe, and comment if you have any questions. And thanks for watching.